Today I'm doing an Amazon haul. This video showcases everything that I bought. Some of these items you guys have been asking me to try for the longest time. And also I picked up a few bits and bobs here and there. So if you're interested to see everything that I bought, keep watching. So the first thing that I picked up was the Saint Botanica Go Curl Shampoo. And this is a shampoo that I featured in my CG friendly shampoos video. If you haven't seen that video, I'm gonna put it up right here and also link down below. So I've tried this shampoo twice, so I can't really give you a review. But if I had to tell you what I thought about the shampoo, I feel like it's really moisturizing. And when you use the shampoo, you'll notice that this feels like a lotion. And so if you have a dry scalp, then maybe you could use this. But whenever you're using a shampoo that is more like a conditioner, more on the super moisturizing side, you have to be careful, because if you have any moisturizing ingredients on your scalp, that can build up really fast and that can clog your scalp. A clogged scalp will give you hair fall. So you have to be really, really careful. This is not something that I would have probably tried during the summer, but since we're approaching winter and my scalp gets a tiny bit dry, not too much, but just a little bit, I'm gonna give this shampoo a try. And once I have all of my thoughts, I'll definitely make a review. But so far, I've been really liking this shampoo. I feel like it's a bang for your buck. I paid 357 rupees for this shampoo. It retails for 400 rupees plus, but they're always on discount. And so if you're looking for a super moisturizing shampoo, maybe you could try this out. But definitely be careful and make sure you're rinsing this off your scalp properly once you're done cleaning your hair. Another thing that I really liked about this shampoo is that even though it is so moisturizing, it also has a pretty decent lather. And so you feel like you're cleaning your scalp while you're moisturizing it. So there's that. The next is the Go Curls Conditioner by Saint Botanica. I'm gonna leave the prices on the screen somewhere here. And I haven't had a chance to really, really experience this conditioner in all of its glory. I won't be able to tell you about the slip so far because I've only used it twice. My hair was not super tangled when I used this, and so I can't comment on the slip. I felt like it did a pretty decent job, but I'll definitely need at least 2 months to be able to tell you what I think about this slip. To be quite frank, this is how it works. When I take care of my hair during the week and I'm not lazy, then detangling becomes very easy. And on other weeks when I'm editing and my hair is like a ball on my head throughout the week and I've neglected it, that is when detangling becomes much more difficult, right? And on those weeks, I prefer to put a conditioner to test, because then I get to know exactly how much slip the conditioner has and how well it detangles my hair. Fortunately or unfortunately, I've been taking really good care of my hair in the last 2 weeks, and so that opportunity to really test out the slip of this conditioner has still not come. So I'll have to wait for a bit and then update you guys. So far, I like the conditioner. It is really thick. It is really moisturizing. About the slip, I can't yet comment. Next, I picked up the Enliven Gel in the blue variant. I have used this gel in the past quite a bit and I have enjoyed it, but I don't know why. I don't remember the formulation being so watery. So I used this on my last wash day, and for some reason my clumps didn't hold up till like day 7. So I don't know what's up. I don't know what's going on. It seems more watery than I remember it being. So do with that what you will. I will update you guys on the performance of this product as well. Next, we have the LA Hole Styling Gel by Giovanni. This is also such a popular gel in the CG community. If you're in America, I keep getting requests for products in America. So yeah, if you're in the States and you're looking for a gel, this is something that you'll get there. Anyway, this is a gel that I have been asked repeatedly to try, and so far I've used it twice. I think I might have gotten overboard and heavy-handed with the gel because I found it pretty drying. So maybe I'm using too much of it, but the hold is really nice. I really enjoyed this gel. It'll take me again another few months to give you like my proper opinions on the gel, because I definitely feel like it's gonna take me some time to figure out exactly how much I need for my hair. So far, no complaints, but I definitely found it a little drying. But that's probably my fault. Maybe I'm using too much. Next, I picked up the Mom's Co. Natural Protein Conditioner. This is the Unicarton, and this is what the conditioner looks like. Again, this is a budget-friendly conditioner. I spent 306 rupees for this. You'll always find this on discount on Amazon. But again, about the slip, about the performance, it's gonna take me some time to let you know what I think about the product. I've used it once so far, and from what I can tell, I really like it, but it's gonna take me some time. Now, I know this is a haul video, and you're probably wondering if it's a haul, then how come you've used some of these products once and twice? That's because I don't buy everything together. I keep things in my cart, and I wait for like price drops, and whenever that happens, that is when I sort of spend my money. So even though I'm showing you all of these things in one video, I have picked these things up over the course of the last few months, if that makes sense. So yeah, about the conditioner, I'm gonna take some time and then let you know about the slip and performance, etc. All right, so the next two things that I have are styling tools. So this is definitely like a dupe. This is not an original. I'm gonna put up better footage of this. I picked this up. I'm gonna try and style my hair with this and see what I think. And I also picked up what people are calling a dupe for the Denman brush. Now, this is the brush in question. So this is supposed to be a dupe of the Denman brush. I got this recommendation from Flawless Skin Tales by Abhi on Instagram. And what do I think about this? Well, first glance, this definitely does not look like a Denman brush. It doesn't feel like a Denman brush, but I'm excited to try this out. I wanted to add a few points to the stuff that I said in the video. So at first glance, this does look different from a Denman brush. For one, it's much bigger, and also there are more spaces between the bristles. So why does a Denman brush work the way it does? Because of its curved edges and also because of the handle of the brush. You'll see that this dupe has the same curved edges and also a thinner yet longer barrel or handle. So if you're looking for bigger clumps and want to create tension in your hair while styling, then I feel like this brush is going to work. If you want to do Denman rolls, this brush is also going to work. Anyway, I don't want to jump the gun here. I'll definitely try this out and make a video for you guys on the channel. If this works and it's similar to a Denman brush, then that'll be awesome. I definitely feel like you're gonna get thicker clumps with this, but I have to try to let you know for sure. All right, the last two things are not curly hair related, but I'm excited. So as we know, Garnier became cruelty free, and that is amazing. It is so lovely when brands actually make the choice and decide to go cruelty free with their lines. And when that happens, of course, I'm gonna show my support. So I picked up the oil infused micellar water. This is something that I've seen on YouTube so much, but I've never been able to try it. So I'm definitely excited to check this out. Generally, I use like a cleansing balm to take off my makeup, but when I'm using glitter, then it becomes a little difficult. In the past, to take off my glitter, I've used the Primark Eye Makeup Remover Water and the Soap and Glory micellar water, and those worked really well. But since I have no idea when I'll be in the UK next, I definitely needed a micellar water, and so I picked this up. All right, so the very last thing, I picked up the Biotique Biochlorophyll Oil-Free Anti-Acne Gel and Post Hair Removal Soother. So I haven't stepped into like a beauty salon in a very long time. It's been years. And so I generally groom at home, I tweeze my own eyebrows, and I wax my upper lips. And I know that nowadays the whole trend of shaving your face has become really popular, but for some reason I'm too chicken to try it, because I feel like so many things can go wrong. And even though waxing is not the best thing for you, especially your face, because it obviously will loosen your skin, right? I'm still not sure of it. I still wax my upper lip. I'm still too chicken to take the plunge and actually use like a razor on my face. I don't know why. I feel like if my face gets pokey, that's the end of it. But yeah, so I wax my upper lip at home and I also do my eyebrows at home. And when I do, since I have sensitive skin, I definitely need something to soothe my skin so that it doesn't get sensitive and I don't break out. And this is something that I've used for years, and so I can vouch for it. Biotique is a company that does not reveal their full ingredient list. However, since I've been using this for years and it is the only product that actually works on my skin and actually makes a difference. So when I wax my upper lip and my skin gets all red and tingly, especially since I have sensitive skin, this is something that I cannot do without. And even though they don't reveal their full ingredient list, that's fine. In my books, I feel like if a product works, then it just works. And so this is something that I definitely won't be letting go of. Although I wish Biotique did a better job, just give us your full ingredient list. Anyway, those are my 2 cents on Biotique. And so about the product, I like it a lot, and it is the only thing that I've tried so far that actually works for me and does not break the bank. And so I'm keeping this. So that was pretty much it for this video. And if you enjoy hair care, then feel free to check out these videos.